Today in this video, I will solve 5 linear equations from exercise 2.6, and in the next video, I will solve remaining 2 equations, that is remaining 2 statement maths, number 6 and number 7. So let's start from number 1. 8x minus 3 divided by 3x is equal to 2. What we'll do? Below 2 we can assume 1 is there. If nothing is there, it means that 1 is there. Now we can do the cross multiplication, that is numerator into denominator of the opposite side and denominator into numerator in the opposite side, that is cross multiplication. So any number multiplied by 1 is the same number. It means that 8x minus 3 into 1 is 8x minus 3, and here 3x into 2. So we can write 8x minus 3 is equal to 2 into 3 is 6 into x 6x. Now let's see the same term. 8x and 6x are same term, and we can say it's a variable also because the term contains x. What I'll do now, I'll take this 6x in the left side of the equation. So the plus become minus, and this 3 is a constant term. So minus 3, if we take the right side, it becomes plus 3. We can write plus, or it's our wish, we can write. Now 8x minus 6x is 2x is equal to 3. So ultimately we can write x is equal to 3. This 2 will come as a divide, and it is solved here. Let's start solving question number 2. 9x divided by 7 minus 6x is equal to 15. The same type of maths means if nothing is there, we can assume in the denominator 1 is there. Now we'll do the cross multiplication, that is 9x into 1 and 7 minus 6x into 15. So 9x into 1 is 9x only, and here 15 into 7 minus 6x. Why we give this bracket? Most of the student does some mistakes here. What they do? They write 15 into 7 minus 6x. So once you write 15 into 7 minus 6x, it means that you are multiplying only 15 with 7. Once you give the bracket, it means that you need to multiply both 7 with 15 as well as minus 6x with 15. That is the reason we need to give the bracket. So 9x is equal to 15 into 7 minus 15 into 6x. So 9x is equal to 15 7s are 105 minus 6 15s are 90x. So this 9x contains the term x, 90x also contains the term x. It means both are variable, we'll keep in the left side. So 9x and this minus 90x becomes plus 90x is equal to 105. So 9 plus 90 is 99x is equal to 105. What we can do now, this x will become 105 divided by 99. It means this 99 will come as a divide as a denominator. Now here both the terms we can cancel by 3. So 3 3s are 9, carry 1, 3 5s are 15, and here 3 3s are 9 and 3 3s are 9. So after all we get the result as x is equal to 35 by 33, and it is solved here. Now let's start question number 3. Question number 3, if you can see, z divided by z plus 15. Z divided by z plus 15, 4 by 9. You can see in different questions they are giving different values. Here they have given x, here they have given z. Question number 4, they have given y. Wherever all the letters are there, we can assume these letters are nothing but variable. So here already denominator is there and numerator is also there. So the first step we'll do the cross multiplication, that is 9 into z, 9z, and as there is 2 terms, so we will multiply this 4 into, we'll keep inside a bracket like earlier maths. So 9z we can write 4 into z, that is 4z plus 4 into 15. We can write here, or we can write directly 4 into 15, 16. Let me write in the next step. 4z plus 450z, 60. Now you can see, this term contains z, this term also contains z. So both are variable term. We will keep this 4z term in the left side of the equation, which becomes plus 2 minus and 60. 9 minus 4 is 5z. 9z minus 4z is 5z is equal to 60. So we can say the value of z is equal to 60 divides 5. Why divides 5? This 5 will come as a divide, as a denominator. We can cancel 5. 12s are 60. So the value of z is equal to 12. Solved. Now let's start solving question number 4. In this question number 4, we can see that in the right side of the equation, the sign is minus. So what we'll do? Initially, we'll do the cross multiplication, that is 5 into, as there is 2 terms, so we'll take a bracket, 5 into 3y plus 4 is equal to minus 2 into 2 minus 6y. In the next line, 5 into 3y plus 5 into 4, you can do this directly, 5 into 3y, 15y, but I am expanding here so that the things become more easier. So minus 2 into 2, again here minus is there, so we'll write minus 2 into, minus 2 into, as minus sign is there, we'll write in the bracket minus 6y. Now 5 into 3y is equal to 15y plus 5 into 4 is equal to 20, and here 2 into 2 is 4, but sign will be minus because here minus is there, and here minus minus become plus, so we can write now 2 6 are 12y, 2 6 are 12 and y. Now we can see this, now we can see that 15y is a term containing y, and here term containing y is 12y, so this 12y will take the left side because the same term. So minus 12y is equal to minus 4 into, and plus 20 is constant, we'll take the right side, it becomes minus 20. So 15 minus 12y is 3y, minus minus plus, 20 plus 4 is 24, and the symbol becomes, sign becomes minus, so minus 24. So we can write y is equal to minus 24, and this 3 will come as a divide. Now 3, 8 times are 24, so we get the value of y is equal to minus of 8, and it is solved here. Let's start question number 5. Here the question is 7y plus 4 divided by y plus 2 is equal to minus 4 by 3. So the same, we'll do the cross multiplication. 7y plus 4 will give bracket because 2 terms are there. When 2 terms are there, we immediately give bracket. Into 3 is equal to 4 into, it is minus, so it will become minus 4 into y plus 2. Now you can see 3 into 7y plus 3 into 4 is equal to minus 4 into y means minus 4y, we can write, and here plus minus minus, so we can write minus 4 into 2. Now 3 7s are 21y plus 3 4s are 12 is equal to minus 4y minus 4 2s are 8. Let's see the related terms. The same term containing y is 21y and here 4y. So these terms are similar terms, we'll take in the one side, or you can say variable in one side. So 21y and here minus 4y will come the left side, which becomes plus 4y is equal to minus 8, and this plus will come this side, minus 12. So we can see left side variables and right side it's constant. So 21y plus 4y is 25y, minus minus plus, so 12 plus 8, 20, and the sign is bigger one, that is minus 20. So we can write y is equal to minus 20, and this 25 will come as a divide. Now 5, 4 times, and 5, 5 times. So ultimately we get the value of y is equal to minus 4 divided by 5. So these were some simple solutions of the first four maths of exercise 2.6. In the next video, I'll do the solutions of last two maths, that is number 6 and number 7 statement maths. Till then, goodbye.